The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hi children, welcome back to this Disney Guru Chill Ed. Hope you are all doing good at home. Are you not happy? Today I meet you with a different background. Is it nice? Are you happy to see? Yes, I hope you are with a smile watching me on the screen. Yes, let me see your smile. Fine, thank you. Yes, though people are highly civilized, they are into the modern world, they are interested in celebrating certain festivals according to the customs and traditions. Isn't it? Don't we celebrate Onam, Deepavali? Yes. Yes, do you know what tradition and culture is? I hope you know. Yes, you are right. Tradition is the customs and beliefs that is passed down from one generation to another. Whereas culture is the values, beliefs, social norms, behavior according to the certain sect of people of the society. Okay, and do you know what is special about Indian tradition? Yes, you are right. What is it? Yes, the grand aspect of Indian tradition is greeting people saying Namaste. Don't we do that? Yes, what else more? Yes, it is touching the feet of elders to seek blessings. And the main special aspect of Indian tradition is going on with the traditional marriage system, and that is arranged marriage. Hope you all love it, isn't it? Yes. And what else more? Showing hospitality. What do we call it? Aditi Devo Bhava, right? Yes. And it goes on in plenty. And we know quite a lot about Indian tradition and culture. Let me ask you one thing. Are you interested to know more about, or at least something about, Fiji Island? I know you are curious. Yes, for a surprise, you have your friends on the screen. Excited to know who are they or who they are? Yes, it is Anandalakshmi and Samran who is going to share the screen space to give or to explore the Fiji Island, their tradition and culture. Are you ready to welcome them? Yes, here you go. Time goes. 3, 2, 1. Yes, let me welcome Samrin and Anandalakshmi to join you to know more about the third lesson of the third unit, Beyond the Horizon. You are right, the lesson, the title goes like this. The Sacred Turtles of Kandavu. Over to the screen to Samran and Anandalakshmi.
Smappy day all.
Hi, I Samran.
And this is Anandalakshmi. Hope you all enjoyed the serene aerial trip of Lee Horla. How was it, Samran?
It was really beautiful. The glimpses of the hot air balloon was an enormous toy, free and designed, which obeys the surprising sensitiveness, right?
Yes.
After knowing all these things, I wish I need to explore more to the cultures of the world.
As Samrin wishes, we have an opportunity to be grabbed to explore through the Fijian island through our lesson, The Sacred Turtles of Kandavu.
Wait. I know what is this Kandavu Island and this sacred turtles and all. But our friends might get confused regarding this. So can you please explain about that?
Sure, dear. Kandavu is one of the largest Fijian islands located in the Namauna village. Do you know where Namauna village is? It is residing at the foot of beautiful Bay Island adjacent to the government station in Vinusi Arbor.
Here, the Kandavu Island, this island just narrows down to an isthmus. It narrows to an isthmus, and by climbing the hill behind this Namauna village, one can stand at the saddle and look to the sea to the north and to the south. Isn't it warm and pretty interesting?
Of course, dear, but I have some doubts. As she was explaining the marine beauty of Kandavu Island, don't you think people must take a long distance journey to travel in this place? So how people are managing this?
Though it is very difficult to manage, the legends over there says that the strong warriors, you know, they use the word the strong warriors. That itself shows that this situation is really risky and tough. What they do is, they just slid their canoes to the rollers up, to the narrow neck of the land to adjust with the long journey towards the, around the east and the west of this Kandavu Island. And this island not only holds speciality in maintaining such type of things, but it also holds speciality in their cultures as well as rituals too. Can you please say about that?
Of course, dear. As Samreen was indicating about the beauty of physical landscapes in Kandavu Island, I need to mention that Kandavu Island's speciality is not confined to marine beauty. It is embedded with traditions, customs and rituals too, which are the real self of that particular island. All their rituals are quite interesting, and one among them is more interesting. Do you want to know about it?
Yes, of course.
Of course, all our friends are really curious to know about the rituals and customs of Fijian Island, especially Kandavu Island. Well, the most interesting ritual is preserved by the Namauna women in Kandavu Island. They have a strange ritual of calling turtles from sea. Can you believe it?
No, I can't believe this. Is this a fairy tale or what?
Even I thought it like that. But it is not a fairy tale. It happens in reality where the Namauna women call the turtles from sea, and we can see that the turtles are appearing in the surface of the sea, one above the other one.
Wow, that's beautiful.
And the particular area where these turtles are coming is forbidden from fishing too.
Okay, so they are concentrating into this conservation of marine ecosystem too,
exactly,
right? Okay. And another important or another interesting sideline of this performance is that if any citizen from the nearby village Nabu Kelav is present over there, these turtles won't arise at the bay. That is interesting, right? I have wondered what is the reason behind this. Do you know?
I know.
Okay, then just...
There is an interesting fable behind this ritual, and why when such particular villages are coming and these turtles are not appearing. So can I move to that story?
Yeah.
Okay. There lived a lovely princess called Tineko Bogu and her charming daughter called Raudalais. Raudalais and her mother had a habit of moving to the reefs of the beach for fishing. One day, something very strange happened.
What is that?
When these two royal women went for fishing, unknowingly, they were moving to the boundaries of the Nabu Kelav village. Actually, what happened is that they crossed this boundary of Namauna village unknowingly as they were engrossed in fishing. And they moved to the premises of this Nabu Kelav village. And what happened is that the cruel men who were traveling on the Nabu Kelav village's war canoe saw these royal maidens and they seized them. Just imagine their condition.
I can't believe that the queen and the princess of that particular place got captivated. We all speak about women empowerment. Let me ask, our women empowerment is practiced, do we practice that in our society?
Though we speak a lot about women empowerment and its importance, the reality is that women are not getting empowered in the contemporary society, as well as they were treated as weaker sense even in those times.
We can say that women are considered as a weaker sex in all the time, right?
Of course. Even when we are going through our present society, dowry system, and most
domestic violence,
these all problems are chasing women. And the most pathetic thing is that in most of the houses, men orders and women obeys.
Yes.
That's the real condition.
Okay, then what happened with the story? Come back.
Yeah. So coming back to the story, these women were kidnapped and they were tossed into the bottom of the canal, and these Nabukalava men started journey back to their village.
Okay. So did they had any way to be rescued or to be escaped?
Just imagine, Samreen, when all means to be rescued or to be saved is unavailable, what will we do?
We just pray to the Almighty to save us from what we are in.
Of course, dear. Even these royal maidens started praying to the gods of the sea to be rescued. So they started praying, and fortunately the gods of the sea were so kind and they created a great storm which made this war canoe swamped with water and it sank. Now we all will have a question, what happened to these
two maidens?
Yes, of course. So these two women were changed into turtles and the men were astounded to see this.
Unbelievable.
Okay. Though it is unbelievable, fate again played its role.
Yes.
Though these women were changed into turtles, they were seized and thrown into the sea by these men.
Oh, so cruel. Okay, how did the weather react to this?
Well, as soon as these women changed into turtles were thrown out of the canoe, the weather became normal.
Okay, so let me ask you one question.
Sure, dear.
While performing this ritual, do they do any special type of songs or something to call these turtles? Do they chant something?
Actually, what happens is that the Namuna women are calling the descendants of these royal maidens.
So they have to call with such a respect and happiness, right?
Yes, so they chant a strange song, which means that every woman in Namuna are feeling so sad as they are missing their two royal maidens.
And they are mourning, right?
Yes, and they are tattooed by a sacred cleft which is having a specific pattern.
Okay, so from this story we can see that all these rituals are maintaining unity, oneness, harmony among people. And apart from this, at one side we can see that we are focusing into the conservation and protection of our ecosystem too. When she said about all these type of rituals, some of the rituals that we practice in our daily lives came to my mind. That is Deepavali, which marks the victory of Rama over Ravana and which plays good over the evil. Dasara. Then Onam, which is the festival of
Halloween.
Yes, yes, Halloween. Onam, we all know, we all celebrate once in an year. It's about Mahabali, and all such type of festivals are coming into our mind, which maintains unity, oneness, harmony. So
that's all our part. So let us remind all of you once again that every ritual and custom has its own importance in this scientific era.
And that is very worthy too.
Yes, they not only protect and promote welfare of the mankind, but also they protect our nature, our mother too.
So that's all our part. See you in the next class. Tada.
Bye bye. Stay happy and stay
smappy. Hi children, welcome back. Hope your friends have shared with us
the strange experience or strange ritual of the Fijian island. And this experience are gained only by traveling. Definitely, traveling opens up our mind, strengthens up your energy, as well as boosts you up for the further wonderful life. Is it not? And hope you will be reading this lesson to ponder more into the Fijian island's strange ritual. Fine? Yes. So the assignment that I would like to give you is with the topic, no? Page number 94. Who do you think are really punished? The Nabukelavu fishermen or the two women from Namauna? Discuss the situation in the present context of atrocities against women. So now your role is to write favoring and against this topic. Okay. Hope you enjoyed the session developed by your friends, and you'll be doing these works and you'll be posting it in my WhatsApp. Okay. Thank you all. We'll meet you next week. Hope you'll be revising all the previous lessons and you'll be doing your exams with the mood of celebration. Okay. Meet you next class. Until then, bye.